Hey guys, Photoshop Pro Help here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create this awesome art paper effect. Now, as you can see, this is what the effect looks like, and if I zoom in and show you, you can get this really nice heavy patterned canvas style effect, and it looks like it's been painted on now. Now, if I just zoom out, and this looks like a stunning picture. Now, if I show you with the effect off, so this is with the effect off, and it's a fairly nice picture on its own, and apply the effect again, and this is what we end up with again. So we're going to try and recreate this now. So you want to go and put a high definition image into Photoshop. Now, this won't work as well with low definition images. Now, this effect really does work especially well with landscapes and open areas, so a lot of sky in your pictures, and it really will bring it out and look fantastic. So have a play around with it. It might work for your image with if you only have a little bit of sky in, and it might not, so really play around with the settings for this. So we're going to go and jump over to our image. This is the one we're going to be working with. And the first thing we're going to be doing is we're going to go and make a new blank layer. So bottom right hand side, new blank layer icon. And then from here, we're going to go and fill it with white. So make sure you've got white as your foreground color. And go to edit, fill, and then foreground color, and OK. From here, all we're going to do is go up to filter. We're going to go to add noise. And we're going to go to around about 20%, but depending on how big your image, you want to play around with this. But I'm going to keep it for 20%. We don't want too much, so try 20% first, and if it doesn't work, then just go back and redo it. Click OK. And the next thing we're going to do is go back up to filter. We're going to go to filter gallery, and from here we're going to go down to sketch, and we want to go to half tone pattern. So we're going to go for a size of 8, contrast of 7, and make sure you've got the pattern type as dot. So you can play around with size and contrast, but I will say try all these settings first, and if it doesn't work, go back and tweak them. Click OK, and we're going to go back up to filter again. We're going to go to filter gallery. We're going to go to wallpaper. And for the wallpaper settings, we're going to have fiber length 50, brightness 85, and contrast 75. So as I said, play around with them, see what this creates for your image. Click OK, and then go back up to filter. We're going to go back to filter gallery, and we're going to go to brush strokes now, and go to sprayed strokes. Now for this one, what we want is we want to go and put 6 for stroke length and 11 for spray radius. Now we want to keep with stroke direction right diagonal depending on your picture. I'm going to keep with this because it works really well. It should work just as fine with your image. Click OK again. And then from here, as you can see around the edges, it's a bit weird pattern around it. So we're just going to go and press Control and T on our keyboard to free transform, or Command and T if you have a Mac. And I'm just going to go and just bring these out just so they're hidden like that. And then click the tick icon at the top. And we're going to go and duplicate this layer now, so Control and J, or Command and J if you have a Mac on your keyboard. Now from here we're going to go up to filter, render, and fibers. Now I'm going to keep with a variance of 5 and a strength of 1. Now you can change the strength to 2. I will suggest trying 2 first, but I've gone for 1 because it's a lot easier to get the next step. So I'm just going to go and zoom out here so we can see the full image inside the box, and what we're after is slight grey. So we're going to go and click the randomize button, and I will say this will take quite a while because if we click the randomize button, you'll see it's get all these dark patches, and we don't want that. We just want white to grayish, so we're just gonna have to keep going to randomize until we get the right one. When you found the right one, we're gonna go and click OK, but I don't need to do that because I've already got mine. So this is what you'll end up with right here. So this is the sort of thing we want. So I'm just gonna go and delete that one, and we're gonna go to image rotation and then 180, and we're gonna go and duplicate that layer again. So Control and J, and then we're gonna go up to filter, we're gonna go back to render fibers and zoom out, and we're gonna go back to randomize. Now we want to have a similar sort of effect, so white to grayish and no black into it, so it will take quite a while. So once you have found it, we're gonna go and click OK. I don't really need to do this because I've already found my one. So this is the style that we're aiming for the second step, and then from here all we're gonna do is we're just going to make sure we have that selected, and we're gonna go and put this to lighten. So put that to lighten, and that blends the two fibers together. So we're gonna go and select those two and then merge them together. So Control on your keyboard or Command, hold that down and select the two, and then right click and then press merge layers. And then for the next, we're gonna go and change the blending option for this to multiplier, click that, and we're gonna go and merge these together as well. So select them again, Control on your keyboard or Command, right click and then press merge layers. And then from here, all we're going to do is going to change the blending mode to this, and there's three different kind of blending modes you can go for this. You can either go for multiply, and that brings a really dark heavy tone to the image, or you can go for overlay or soft light. So soft light is just underneath overlay and it's a little bit lighter. So I'm just going to go for overlay for this, and we're going to go change to image and go to image rotation and 180, and I'm just going to go and bring this down a little bit, just a tad, so it's around about there. Now you can really play around with the opacity. You don't really need to change the opacity down depending on your type of image. So I'm just going to go to the bottom now, and I'm going to go and duplicate this. So I'm going to duplicate the bottom image, so Control and J or Command and J if you have a Mac, and then I'm going to go up to filter gallery, and we're going to go to sprayed strokes again, but we're going to change all the settings to 0 and then click OK. And then I'm going to bring the opacity down to around about 67%, should be okay for that. And then there we have it. That's exactly what we want. How easy was it? So you can really create some stunning effects with this. So go and have a go, try it out, and don't forget you can merge all these layers into one and then save your image from there. So as I said, if it doesn't work for your image first time, go back, try it again, and tweak the settings until it's right for you. So please comment, rate, and subscribe. Go check out my website, guys. Go check out Facebook and the new Google Plus on my channel. And I'll see you next time, guys. Bye for now.